Hey everyone, Haley from Biteable here. Today we're going to make a video to announce a new product. Let's get started. So we're going to get started here on Biteable's template page, and I will just use the search bar to enter in a keyword like announcement. This is going to be more of an internal announcement to let my team know that this product launch is coming up. So once I find the template that I like, I'll just go ahead and click edit video. This will launch the template in the Biteable Video Maker. Now I'm going to make quite a few changes to this template, so I'll show you how simple it is to do that. I'm going to be letting my team know that we're launching a new dog collar. So these animations don't really work for my video. I'm gonna go ahead and click replace background. Here I could upload my own footage, use Biteable's animations, or I could search through Biteable's stock footage library as well, which is what I'll do here. I just want a nice little video of a dog to celebrate the launch of this dog collar. So here that replaced the animation on half of the screen, but I want my video to be the full background, so I'm just going to go ahead and double click and resize that background video here. And once that's done, I can click on my text, rearrange that, and make it a little bit easier to see on the scene. I'm also going to jump up to the video settings and turn the watermark off, so that will remove the watermark from all of my video scenes. Heading into the next scene here, this is going to be a very high level video, just going to let my team know what we're launching, when we're launching it, and where they can ask questions. So I'll go ahead and update my text in this text box here. And once again, this animation doesn't really match my text, so I'm going to go ahead and click replace background, and this time I will replace it with a Biteable animation. And I'll use the search bar to look for an animation that fits the scene a bit better, like a calendar. Once that animation has been added into the background, I can just go ahead and move things around. I'm not too worried about the colors in every scene right now, because we will go through and update that at the end of the video. And finally, this last scene is where I want to let people know where they can send their questions if they have any. So I'll just add my little closing statements here with the email address. And again, animation doesn't really match the scene, so we're gonna go ahead and click on the animation and then select replace background one more time, and we will find a new background scene. Great, now I have one more scene at the beginning of this video that's just an extra little scene to make a fun transition, but I don't really want that in this video, so I'm going to go ahead and delete that opening scene as well. And next we're going to head into the style tab. This is where we can make bulk style changes across our video, so I'm going to choose a new background color for these scenes, maybe some sort of green so it matches the video in the first scene. And you can see how quickly these changes are applied once you select your new color. So I'm just gonna go ahead and update my animation colors as well so everything looks nice and cohesive. And once that's done, I can go ahead and jump back into the edit tab. Now there's already a soundtrack applied to this video, so if I did wanna change that, I could do that here, but I'll leave it as is for the example. And then we'll go ahead and build the video, and here is what your final video would look like. That's all it takes. If you're ready to give it a try, head to biteable.com where you can sign up for a free 7-day trial. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time. Bye.